This is moments before disaster. Here, let's rewind a bit. Oh, such a nice day to relax. Got my sunglasses and everything. Let's see. Oh, interesting. What was that? Oh, I'm all wet now. Oh. Wait. Is that a tsunami? Obviously, that's not a real tsunami. And obviously, I overreacted a little bit. Run! Okay, maybe not a little bit, maybe a lot. But you get it. This episode is all about tsunamis. And not just how tsunamis are caused and how they form and how they're so destructive, but answering this amazing question about this natural phenomena. It is, could you outrun a tsunami? Could a human, or even the fastest runner on Earth, or even the fastest animal on Earth outrun a tsunami? Well, in this episode, you're gonna find out, so stick around until the end. Let's get right into a deep dive and hopefully don't get hit by this amazing tsunami science. Let's go. So what causes tsunamis? Well, first, let's look at the word tsunami. The tsunami is a combination of two Japanese words, tsu, meaning harbor, and nami, meaning wave. Together, it means harbor wave. Tsunamis are ginormous waves that are caused by large disturbances in the ocean. They can be caused by earthquakes, underwater volcanic eruptions, and very, very rarely, meteors. Now, let's get right into how these tsunamis are formed. Tsunamis are formed because of these giant shockwaves, and when these volcanic eruptions or earthquakes happen, the energy all gets released. And when the energy gets released underwater, it creates a shockwave, and the shockwave spreads around. You know how when you drop a rock into a puddle or a pond, it kind of has those ripples that come out? Well, that's kind of how tsunamis are formed. Imagine that a rock as the earthquake, and when that earthquake or that volcanic eruption happens, all that energy gets pushed upwards into the sea, and that causes disturbance that goes two different ways. A common misconception about tsunamis is that they only go one way, and that's towards land, but that's not true. Tsunami waves go in all different directions. And if you're at sea and we're looking at these tsunami waves that are traveling at so fast, over 500 miles per hour, they would only be about 3 feet tall. Then those waves don't look scary, right? They just travel really, really fast. Well, when it nears the shore, that's when things start to get feisty. When it nears the shore, because the shoreline is obstructing all that energy, remember, waves are just the transfer of energy, not the movement of water. So when that energy gets stopped by the shoreline, it kind of compresses it. It kind of compresses the wave into a small part. And that wave starts to get slower and slower and goes higher and higher. These tsunami waves can go over 100 to 200 feet tall. And these tsunamis, they start to get destructive. It's because of that shoreline. And when it starts squeezing, it slows down more. And all that momentum that's been building up, traveling hundreds of miles across the sea, well, that all gets released. And when a tsunami hits the shoreline, it goes into the shore and goes over a mile inland. So that means you can flood up to a mile away from the shoreline. And these tsunamis can be very destructive, not only because they flood it all, but because after it floods it, a few seconds afterward, the tsunami wave recedes, taking all that new debris with it. And that's why tsunami waves are very, very destructive, and it's important to stay safe from them, especially if you live around coastal and low-lying areas. That's how tsunamis are formed. Before we get on with some more tsunami science, I just want to remind you to hit that subscribe button below and leave a like on this video. Thank you so much. And now on to this amazing tsunami science and answering the mind-blowing questions. And now to answer the burning question, the entire cause of this episode. Could you outrun a tsunami? Well, the short answer is sadly no. You can't outrun a tsunami. Here's why. Tsunamis travel over 500 miles per hour. Trust me, that's really, really fast. Since they travel over 500 miles per hour, no human on foot could even outrun a tsunami, not even a car. It'd have to be a jet airplane to outrun or outfly, I should say, a tsunami, because tsunamis go so fast, over 500 miles per hour.
even the fastest person on the earth could now outrun a tsunami. Isn't that wild? That's why it's really, really important to stay safe from tsunamis, and that's why scientists are working around the clock to find ways to predict these tsunamis and to keep these thousands of people safe. That's why tsunamis are so mind-blowing, and the superhero scientists are helping fight these tsunamis. And when tsunami throws something at you, it's best to stay out of nature's way, because when you can't control something that nature does, it's best to stay out of the way. Alright, let's recap on what we learned in this episode. In this episode, we learned that tsunamis are caused by giant disturbances in the ocean, and those are caused by rarely meteors and mostly earthquakes and underwater volcanic eruptions. These actually cause a large upburst of energy, and this energy travels across the ocean in form of a tsunami, and when it hits shore, that's when it gets really, really tall. And it can go up to 500 miles per hour. Even though it'll only be about 3 feet tall when it's traveling through the ocean, the wave increases in height because it's nearing the shoreline and all that energy is getting compressed together. You cannot outrun a tsunami because it can go over 500 miles per hour, and even the fastest human on Earth could not. Isn't that really, really, really cool? Yep. So, that's the science of tsunamis. Thank you so much for listening to this episode of Spectacular Science. Spectacular Science produced and hosted by me, Akshay J. Raman. Our theme song and additional music are by Charan Ramachandran. Please visit my website, spectacularsci.com, to find interactive activities, articles, and blog posts. That's spectacularsci.com. Do you have a question that you want answered on a Spectacular Science episode and get a special shout-out? Well, grab a parent or adult and head over to spectacularsci.com/contact. There you can find a contact form. You can contact me and send me all your amazing science questions. Again, that's spectacularsci.com/contact. Please also subscribe wherever you're listening right now. It really encourages me, and you'll be up to date on all the new episodes. Subscribe and share this podcast with your friends and family. Thank you so much. Thanks for listening, and we'll see you on the next episode of Spectacular Science next week. Keep thinking about science!